Anytime that there's self-injurious behavior, we have to ask that other question. Is there suicidal ideation? Or are they thinking about suicide? And we must follow that through if they are. And in fact, self-injurious behavior is a way to stay alive or to feel alive or to calm oneself down instead of committing suicide because they feel things so intensely. So it's important to separate those two out. On the other hand, they do go together. So I'm not talking out of two sides of my mouth. They're different, but they often do go together. And in fact, when someone does self-injurious behavior, they have crossed that boundary between feeling and thinking and behaving on themselves. We also know, if we look at all the risk for suicide, all the independent things that risk suicide, that self-injured behavior is one of those risks.